Hello, my dear students. I welcome you all to your own channel, Innovative Science Tutorials. So today we are going to deal with the last part of the topic, photosynthesis, and that is experiments on photosynthesis. Children, this topic of the chapter photosynthesis is very, very important because the question paper, okay, the question paper of biology for class 7 or 10, okay, this chapter is common for standard 7 and standard 10. It's very important to understand this concept nicely because most of the questions in the question paper are from the activity diagrams and experiments. That is called what? That is called structured application questions. So listen to me attentively, you will understand everything, and in case of any doubt, do ask me, okay, in the comment box. So let's begin. So today we are going to actually see the various experiments to demonstrate the necessity of various factors of photosynthesis. So first of all, we'll do starch test. How we perform a starch test, we'll see that, okay, we'll learn together. And next is de-starching. Now let me tell you, starch test and de-starching, beta, these are actually what I have included them under experiment heading, but they are some basic steps or requirement or test that need to be performed before performing one or the other experiment on photosynthesis. When we will learn together, that time you will observe that yes, in some experiments it is compulsory to do starch test, whereas in some of them de-starching is required before the experiment, and in some you will find that both de-starching and starch test are required to be done before performing the experiment or after performing the experiment as and when required. So these are the two, starch test and de-starching. Next is beta, that will be the actual first experiment to show that chlorophyll is necessary for photosynthesis. Next is to show that light is necessary for photosynthesis. And finally, to show that oxygen is given out during the process of photosynthesis. So all these experiments, either they require both starch test or de-starching, or they require only starch test, or they require only de-starching. But in most cases, you will find that both are required. So let's begin without wasting any more time, children. So our first experiment is experiment number one, that is starch test. See, student, this is not in your textbook like this. I have included it because this is the foremost important thing that is required for photosynthesis experiments. If we don't know the starch test, we cannot perform any test of photosynthesis, because all the experiments of photosynthesis, they require a starch test for confirmation of photosynthesis. So let us see what is a starch test, what are the materials required for it. Children, the materials required for photosynthesis are a beaker, a tripod stand, a petri dish, test tube, water, iodine solution, alcohol, dropper, glass rod, Bunsen burner, forceps, and water bath. What are all this? I will show you right now. Don't worry. So this is the setup. You can see, children, this is the Bunsen burner, this one I was talking about. This is boiling water inside this glass container, okay, here it is, and we have taken a leaf. So let us read from here. First of all, what we have to do, children, for conducting this experiment, we pluck a leaf from where? From a plant which has green leaves. We pluck a green leaf, not variegated leaf. We will pluck a green leaf, and then what we will do, just look at the diagram, children, and carefully listen to me. You will understand everything properly. First of all, we have taken a leaf, and then we have dipped it inside boiling water. Where have we dipped it? Inside boiling water. You can see in the diagram this one, first one, this one,
ओके एंड आफ्टर बॉइल लीविंग द लीफ इन बॉइलिंग वाटर फॉर फ्यू मिनट्स वी विल टेक इट आउट. ओके वी विल टेक इट आउट एंड वी विल पुट इट इनसाइड अ टेस्ट ट्यूब. वेयर वी विल पुट इट, वी विल पुट दिस लीफ इनसाइड अ टेस्ट ट्यूब कंटेनिंग एल्कोहल. विच एल्कोहल चिल्ड्रन? C2H5OH, दैट इज योर इथानॉल. C2H5OH, दैट इज योर इथानॉल. वेट, आई एम राइटिंग. So this is the formula for ethanol or ethyl alcohol. Now what is the reason behind putting it in boiling water? We put it in boiled water to soften the leaf, okay, and to kill the cells. Main thing that why do we boil the leaf is to kill the cells. We cannot experiment on living cells. So first we kill the cells by boiling it in water. Then what we do, we remove the chlorophyll. How we remove the chlorophyll? By putting the leaf in our test tube containing alcohol. Which alcohol? Ethyl alcohol. Ethyl alcohol is also known as ethanol. And where we have to place the test tube, children? You can see over water bath. This type of arrangement, when one test tube is kept over another beaker having boiling water and getting heated up by a Bunsen burner from the bottom. Okay, this is your water bath, this type of arrangement. Okay, so directly we are not heating the test tube. Okay, what we have done, instead we have kept it over the hot water or boiling water. Now after some time what happens, we will see that the leaf becomes decolorized. Why? Because it is the responsibility of this ethanol to remove the chlorophyll. Okay, now after that we will take it out from the test tube, and what we will do, children? We will keep it in cold water again, once again, not hot water now. Now normal water we will take. We will place this decolorized leaf in normal water for some time, and then once again with the help of forceps we will place it on a petri dish or on a glass slide as per our convenience. Now after placing it on the desired surface, what we will do, we will take some iodine solution in our dropper and we will put that iodine solution drop wise on the leaf. Now what happens next, can you guess? Children, if the leaf turns blue black, that means photosynthesis has taken place. But how? Because blue black color indicates the presence of starch. Okay, if the iodine solution turns blue black, that means the leaf has performed photosynthesis and it contains what? It contains starch. But in case there is no change in the color of the iodine solution, then what will happen, students? Then that means no photosynthesis has taken place and there is no stored starch in the leaf. So this experiment was very, very important. It is called starch test. Okay, children. Now next is experiment number 2. In this case, we will learn how to de-starch a plant. What is the meaning of de-starch here, children? D means to remove. Okay. And de-starch means to remove starch. So this is again one of the prerequisite for the experiments of photosynthesis after starch test. Both of these are required. In fact, these starch test is required for almost all the experiments of photosynthesis, but de-starch is required in some of the experiment. Now what is the meaning of de-starch? De-starch means to remove the starch present in the leaf. Okay, for this what we have to do, we will keep the potted, we will take a potted plant on which we have to perform the experiment, we have to pluck the leaf and test for photosynthesis. We will place that entire potted plant in a dark room for about 24 to 48 hours. In doing so, whatever starch will be present in the leaves, children, that will get converted into sucrose and utilized by the cells to liberate energy. Means basically all of the stored form of glucose, that is starch, will be utilized within this period of 24 to 48 hours, and there will be no starch left. Why? Because now the plant is in the dark room, it cannot perform photosynthesis. So this is what is your D starch. Children, next is experiment number 3, and this is very important experiment. Here we have to show that chlorophyll is necessary for photosynthesis. How can we prove, how can we say that yes, chlorophyll is very necessary for photosynthesis? For this, we have to perform the experiment and prove it. So what are the materials we require? We require a variegated leaf, a green leaf, and all apparatus used in performing starch test. So variegated leaf means what? Leaf like leaf of money plant, show plant. Okay, I am giving one example, money plant. Variegated leaf means a leaf with multiple colors. So one example that I have taken here is money plant. We have so many examples, children. Okay. Then we will take a green leaf and all the apparatus of starch test. So what we have to do, children? First we will take a potted plant with variegated leaves like money plant or croton plant and keep it in a dark room, okay, for 3 days. Why we are keeping it in a dark room for 3 days, children? To de-starch it. Just before some time I taught you, in order to de-starch it. This will halt photosynthesis. Naturally, it will stop photosynthesis because the potted plant will be kept inside a dark room where there is no sunlight. So without sunlight, we cannot even think of photosynthesis. So photosynthesis will completely stop, but respiration will continue, and because of the respiration, the stored starch will get converted into sucrose and utilized for cellular respiration to release energy for the plant to stay alive. So completely the plant will become de-starch. Then what we will do, children? Then after de-starching for 3 days, we will take that potted plant out in sunlight and we will keep it in the sunlight for 6 to 8 hours. The plant can now carry out photosynthesis naturally because it is now placed in sunlight, so it can carry out photosynthesis and it will produce glucose that will be stored in the form of starch. Now mark the green areas in the leaf and trace them on a sheet of paper. Mark the regions as green and yellow. The green areas contain chlorophyll, which is absent in the yellow areas. Why, beta? Why chlorophyll is absent in the yellow areas? Because if chlorophyll would have been present, that area would have been green only. It is due to the chlorophyll that the leaf looks green. Then what we will do? Once again, we will perform the starch test. How we do the starch test, children? First of all, we boil the leaf, isn't it? For some time, 2-3 minutes, hardly 2-3 minutes in boiling water. Then we put it inside a test tube containing alcohol in order to remove the chlorophyll, that is to decolorize the leaf. Then once again, we place it in a petri dish kind of thing or a beaker containing normal water, okay, in order to soften the leaves. Why? Because when we put the leaf in the alcohol, na children, that time the leaf become brittle. Brittle means kachkada like. It can easily break. So in order to remove that brittleness, we put it once again in normal water so that it can become soft. Then what we do? We put some drops of iodine solution with the help of a dropper. If in this case, let us see what happens. Dip this decolorized leaf in iodine solution, or we can put iodine solution drop wise with the help of a dropper. Now remove the leaf from the iodine solution and rinse it in distilled water. Remove the leaf from the distilled water and keep it on a petri dish. Two colored regions are visible. See children, what we did? We did the iodine test, and after doing the iodine test, we found this type of appearance of the leaf. The green portions, these green portions of the leaves, they became blue after the experiment, after the iodine test. But the colored area, the yellow region, these area were yellow, isn't it? These were yellow and these were green. The yellow region, they remain unchanged. There was no effect. They kept persistent the brown color of the iodine solution. So it is very clear from this experiment that only the parts of the leaf which are green in color, containing chlorophyll, only they are capable of performing photosynthesis, but rest of the parts which do not contain chlorophyll, they cannot perform photosynthesis. I hope this is clear, children. I expect, in case of any doubts, you will comment me in the comment box. The next experiment is to show that sunlight or light is necessary for photosynthesis. Now, what are the materials required for this, children? We need a potted plant, we need black paper, we need clips, and all the requirements of starch test again. See, I told you starch test will be required in almost all the experiments related to photosynthesis. Excuse me, children. Now next, let us see that how we are going to perform the experiment. First of all, once again, we will take a potted plant. We will keep it in a dark room for 2 to 3 days in order to destarch the leaves, in order to remove all the starch present in the leaves of that plant. Then what we will do, children, on the day of experiment, we will cover a part of its leaf, only a part of its leaves, with the strip of black paper. And we will also make sure that we cover both the side of the leaf, not only on the top, because the lower surface is also capable of performing photosynthesis. Not only the upper surface of the leaf, children, the lower surface can also perform photosynthesis. Why? Because both the surfaces contain chlorophyll. Now what we will do, children, after putting the clip, wait, let me show you, you will understand. See, like this, we have to put the black paper with the help of clip to hold the paper, okay? Like this we will do. So, now what we will do, children, after putting the black paper and pressing it with the clips, holding it tightly, we will put the plant in sunlight for 3 to 4 hours. Then we will pluck that particular leaf with which we have to do the experiment, that the one in which we have put the black paper. So we will pluck that selected covered leaf and remove the black paper covering it. We will remove the black paper. Okay. Then we will take out the leaf and boil it in alcohol. That means what, children? We will perform the starch test. Okay, first of all, we will keep it in boiling water for some time. Then, in order to kill the cells, then we will put it inside the alcohol contained in a test tube in order to decolorize the leaf, in order to remove the chlorophyll from the leaf. And finally, what we will do? We will place it in water and take it out. We will place it in normal water. Take it out, place it in a petri dish and add some iodine solution, either drop wise or we can put it in iodine solution itself contained in a petri dish. What we will see, children, let us see. After this experiment, we will observe that the part that was hidden under the black paper from both the side, upper surface as well as the lower surface, did not turn blue-black after the starch test. Only the uncovered areas of the leaf turned blue-black. That means what? The uncovered areas were exposed to sunlight and they were capable to perform the photosynthesis. But this area, children, this area was not able to perform photosynthesis. This white zone, which was hidden under the black paper, we have clipped, isn't it? So that is why it did not get sunlight and it wasn't able to perform photosynthesis. So this experiment proves that sunlight or light is very essential for photosynthesis.
Students, now let us see the experiment number 5. That is the last experiment to show that oxygen is given out during photosynthesis. In order to carry out this experiment, children, we need some materials such as we need hydrilla plant, a test tube, a beaker, water, matchstick or a splinter. So let's begin. First of all, children, we will take a beaker and inside the beaker, what we will place? We will place some water. Only 3/4. We will not fill it completely. We will fill water only up to 3/4. Then next, what we will do? We will take a filter funnel. I am drawing the filter funnel here for you, children. We will take a filter funnel. This is the one that we use in the chemistry lab to do the experiments related to filtration. Next, what we will do? We will place some hydrilla plant on this, inside this filter funnel, in the funnel area, okay, of the filter funnel. Now, after doing this, next, what we will do? Next, we will invert the setup we have created inside the beaker, okay, in water inside the beaker in an inverted position, upside down, okay, inverted position. Now, next, this was the first, second step. First, we fill the beaker up to 3/4, then we have taken a filter funnel and placed some hydrilla plants inside it. Next, in the third step, what we will do, children? We will take a test tube. We will take an empty test tube and then we will place it inverted upside down on, over the filter funnel. Now, our setup is ready. Next, what we will do, children? We will place this entire setup in either sunlight or any bright light, okay, in such a place where there is bright light. This bright light can either be the sunlight or any artificial source of light. For how long we will place this setup? We will place this setup for 2 to 3 hours and leave it undisturbed. We won't do anything. Then next, what we will do, children? Next, after 2 to 3 hours, we will come back to our setup and what we will notice, we will observe that some molecules, some gaseous molecules are clearly visible inside the water that is present in the test tube. Not only that, initially the level of the water was supposed here. Wait, I am showing you, children. Suppose initially the level of water was here due to these. Let me change the color. Due to this, children, these gaseous molecules, the water starts shifting down gradually. Why? Because these gaseous molecules, we don't know which gas is this. We have to prove it that this is oxygen. These are lighter, so they shift upward and water is displaced down. This is called what? Downward displacement of water. Now, next, what happens? Once this test tube gets filled with, suppose till here with the gas. Okay, we don't know what is the name of the gas now. We have to do the test and find it out whether it is oxygen gas. That is what is our experiment about. So we will take this test tube out of the beaker
After 2 to 3 hours, after observing that yes, there are some bubbles of an unknown gas that has evolved and that has caused downward displacement of water, and the molecules of this gas themselves, they have occupied this is area of the test tube, this zone of the test tube. So once this test tube gets filled up, wait, I am showing. Once this test tube gets filled up, suppose still here with this gases, then what we will do, we will take this test tube out and we will do a test for the presence of oxygen gas. What is that test, beta? Very simple, but we have to be very careful. We have to bring a glowing splinter near the mouth of the test tube very, very carefully. Now see the flame. It is not glowing too much, isn't it? But as soon as it comes near the mouth of the test tube, it starts glowing more brightly. So this proves that the gas which is inside the test tube is oxygen gas, because oxygen gas is the gas that supports burning, that supports combustion. So with this, we prove that oxygen gas is released during the process of photosynthesis.
Okay students, with this we complete the chapter photosynthesis, and very soon we will meet once again with a new topic in a new class. But before that, children, let me tell you one thing, that if you are really finding my classes and videos useful to you, especially during the pandemic period when you are attending the online classes, then please like and subscribe my channel, and do not forget to press the bell icon in order to get all the notifications related to uploads and live classes. So that's all for today. See you all in the next class, children. Thank you.